Now, go has another special keyword. I don't remember the history of where it comes from. It's called iota. And iota to me is still kind of confusing, but what it does is it gives you in a block. So what's interesting is Go has this syntax for blocks. We tend to only see the syntax mostly for imports. Okay, you'll see import blocks. You'll see constant blocks a lot because of iota. I've seen people use type blocks as well. I mean, from my perspective, I would only use a block if it's going to make the code easier to read. Okay. So I don't know if I have any production code that uses type blocks. Maybe I might somewhere. Maybe for a collection of maybe error types or something. I don't know. You don't see it for type very often. You will see it for imports, and you'll see it for constants quite a bit. I just want to show you it's not just restricted to imports and constants. So this is just so you don't have to say constant over and over and over again. And iota only works in a block anyway. So anytime you start a constant block like this, for every line in the block, iota starts at 0 and then increments automatically by 1. So just by assigning this to iota, a1 becomes 0, b1 becomes 1, c1 becomes 2. It's an automatic increment. But what's kind of cool is, like, you wouldn't do this over and over again. You only have to list it once, and you get the rest of those constants in the block. They get it for free. So if I saw this in code, I'd be like, what are you doing? Let's just assign it once. Iota takes that 0 value on that first line, and then you would get it 1 and 0. Now, if you really wanted to use iota and start at 1, you'll see people performing math here, like this. So here we're saying what we really want is A3 to start at 1, not at 0. Iota is always going to start at 0, so you'll see people do math against it. And one of the things you'll see in the log package is this. If you're looking to create a set of constants that are going to be flags, so you can do kind of bitwise operations, you'll see the bitwise shifting. So if you're shifting one bit to the left, like this, then you get these bit patterns that can be used in OR and operations. You'll see this is very much used in the log package. And it's all just based on this. So this entire shift now copies down the block. One gets shifted by 0, one gets shifted by 1, one gets shifted by 2. You get it all for free. Some really cool stuff that you might see. So, you know, if I run all of this, and it finally ran, you're seeing that iota is starting at 0 every step of the way here. Okay? So some basic iota stuff right there.